Hey everybody, Spark from Wavescape.co.za here with your surf report for the week starting Monday the 31st of August as we head towards spring. And I just wanted to show you a massive update and upgrade to the charts of late, particularly this coastal low that becomes pretty much a cutoff low that brings a huge east swell and brings huge rain. So I'm just going to give you a broader picture of how that all comes about and how that low gets separated from its brethren. Well, the first thing is that the little low that's bringing the storm to us Monday into Tuesday dissipates quite rapidly. And then you can see the low is actually a terrestrial low pressure system that comes down from north of Namibia and moves south. Of course, this being clockwise rotating, warm, moist air rising. And that high pressure system extends in a band around, basically cutting it off from the rest of the low pressures. And that's, I guess, what you call a cutoff low. So having a look at what happens on Wednesday morning, Cape Town is kind of like in a weird eye, but there's big east winds off the east coast. The low moves south of the country, just going on to wind gusts. So basically lots of south and east swell ahead. So if we have to look at the waves for this and watch that low as it comes down, imagining all that wind that's blowing east, and there's the swell increasing, getting bigger and bigger. Northeast 8.3 meters at 12 seconds. Pretty crazy stuff. So if we had to look at the Cape Peninsula and look there, we'd see there's all the east wind, and then the swell is going to be a lot more south to southeast. But if you go and have a look at the Southern Cape, 20 foot east swell at 12 seconds on Wednesday at 8 o'clock. Big east winds, and then a strong northwesterly becoming gale force westerly buster. So, and then Thursday, strong winds dissipating, but the swell's rapidly dissipating too. And then more busters. So winter has definitely not let us out of her grip yet. And then heading up the east coast as far as the south coast of KZN, they also get affected quite seriously by that northeast component of that cutoff low. I mean, check it Tuesday, strong east winds becoming pumping northeast winds. And then Wednesday, gale force to 39 knots of northeast wind. And then Thursday, an absolutely broken, savaged sea with stiff leftover northerlies in the early hours, and then dying off into a calm, glassy day with a big northeast washy wind swell, pretty much. So yeah, Monday actually looks like quite a fun day early, but otherwise not much going for KZN right now after that sublime run of swell you guys had, which I guess you are grateful for. You can see big northeast winds pumping down the coast, down the east coast on Wednesday. Terrible conditions. And then howling northwesterly gale force conditions across large parts of the Cape. And then turning into a southwesterly buster along the Southern Cape and Eastern Cape. It's kind of gone on Thursday. So as that cutoff low is doing its thing in South Africa, there is a morass of wind in the deep ocean, centered around this 951 millibar low, but fairly fragmented with big wind fetches scattered across a vast area. And then into Wednesday, that starts to consolidate into two main areas of wind. The first around a 971 millibar storm with central wind around the 55 to 60 knot range. And then a second fetch behind it around a low of 963 millibars. And you see them progress into Thursday, dropping away, but not before sending plenty of swell our way. That's going to bring swell for days. And then this third guy here also winds to 60 knots, gusts that is, and that heads our way for long enough to bring another long period powerful ground swell before it also starts to drop away. And then of course this other low pressure system to the west is also going to be bringing some interesting conditions, but that's later into next week. So swell wise, wave watch 3, we've got on Tuesday a 3 meter southwest swell running, and then this east swell is going to be rapidly overlaid across that. So you're just going to be seeing the east swell. Terrible conditions, of course, doesn't really matter about the other swell. So eventually that low pressure system will move away. Thursday night, there it goes, moving away, which is cleaning up the ocean enough for the charts to then show the next oncoming swell. So that swell is going to be arriving on Friday, for argument's sake, so that we cover the Cape in general, middle ground, somewhere off of Gullis. By lunchtime Friday, 2.8 meter swell at 13 seconds, getting bigger, 3.6 meters at 14 seconds, 3.7 meters at 16 seconds, 3.7 meters at 15 seconds on Saturday, and then more swell from the second one, here it comes, 4.2 meters at 16, and then 4.6 meters at 17 seconds overnight Saturday, 5 meters at 17 seconds or so, the early hours of Sunday, and then Sunday going gangbusters all along the coast. And then I just wanted to show the rain. So Monday, nice bit of rain, then that low dissipates. It's not major rain, that's still to come. So Tuesday, here comes the low pressure moving down from the north, and big rains across the Karoo, parts of the Eastern Cape, and lack of rain for the Kuche Dam, hopefully, and for the Eastern Cape dams, some of which are suffering terribly. A band of heavy, heavy rain across from Riviersonderend to Laingsburg, and more rain. With these things, you just never know exactly how they pan out. Needless to say, there's going to be moments of proper... Anyway, guys, that's a little bit of a haphazard report hastily put together for you for this week. But hope you have a good one. Stay safe. Have a few waves. See you in the water. Cheers.